Last night was our hottest March night in 6 years before Sydney endured another sweltering day under clear skies. Plenty of swimmers escaping the heat at Balmoral Beach in Mosman early this morning, the water temperature sitting at a lovely 24 degrees. It soared to 37 degrees in Penrith today, 35 in Blacktown, Liverpool and Campbelltown, 32 in Terry Hills, 34 in Gosford in the city and 37 degrees in Cronulla. Sydney's extreme heat moved to the north coast today. Yamba had its warmest March day in 8 years, reaching 33, while areas around Port Macquarie hit five-year records with tops of 34. Newcastle saw a top of 36, 37 in Grafton and in Narrabri. And tonight there is a severe storm warning for parts of the mid-north coast, the Hunter, the northwest and the northern tablelands. Tomorrow, the tropical low over the Gulf of Carpentaria will continue to bring gusty winds, severe storms and heavy rain with possible flash flooding, while onshore winds around a high will drive a few showers over Tasmania and southern Victoria. Let's take a look around the country. Brisbane is heading for a fine and warm day, 32 degrees, a milder 21 on the way for Canberra. An early shower or two for Melbourne, heading for just 18 degrees. A few showers in Hobart, 16. Shower or two in Adelaide, 20. And possible showers in Perth with a warm 33 degrees. A few showers around the northern tablelands and the southwest slopes tomorrow, while hot and dry conditions combined with fresh and gusty westerlies will bring an extreme fire danger across the central ranges. Everywhere else will be fine and sunny, hot in the north, heading for 31 in Coffs Harbour, 34 in Newcastle and 35 degrees in Narrabri, while along the coast there is a strong wind warning for Byron, Coffs, Macquarie and Eden. Tonight should be a little cooler in Sydney before blue skies tomorrow, with northwesterly winds before a mild southerly change. We're heading for tops of 33 degrees in Richmond, Penrith and Blacktown, 32 in Kellyville, Parramatta and Liverpool, 29 the top for Terry Hills and 31 in the city. That is 6 degrees warmer than average, 28 the top for Cronulla. Let's take a look ahead, and Thursday will be sunny and 27 degrees. A cloudy day on Friday, 27 once again. Blue skies to kick off the weekend. It will start to warm back up again too, 30 degrees on Saturday before a few possible showers on Sunday and early next week. Looking at 1 to 20 millimetres on Monday, so a wide range there. Overnight lows hovering around 18 to 21. In our west, sunny and 30 on Thursday, a cloudy 29 on Friday, heading up to 35 by Saturday before a possible shower or two on Sunday and then those showers on Monday, Pete.
Amber, thank you.
Hello again. We had another cool, partly cloudy day in Melbourne from a low of 15. The city peaked at 23. The gusty winds have been the main feature. They reached gale force through most suburbs early this morning and strengthened again late this afternoon. Up to 78 kilometres an hour at South Channel Island and almost 70 coming off the bay. Statewide, maximums were mostly in the low to mid-20s, but those numbers are a little deceiving. With the strong winds, it didn't feel that nice. These areas in orange remain under a severe weather warning for damaging winds. There's likely to be sustained gales of 60 to 70 kilometres an hour along the exposed coast and damaging gusts of around 90 through 100 for the Grampians and also the Alps. In addition to the gusty winds, an approaching cold front will bring a band of rain and showers, and while it is expected to slip away fairly quickly overnight, it will leave much cooler air in its wake. So we'll have a midweek slump tomorrow with temperatures to take a hit. In good news, we're expecting the bulk of the rain to fall overnight, and not huge numbers are expected, around 10 to 15 millimetres for Wilson's Prom and Warrnambool, and that will be at the higher end. Then tomorrow will be noticeably colder. Ballarat and Hamilton are both expecting to drop to 8 before a top of 15. Otherwise, maximums ranging from 16 to 20 through the south, and maximums in northern Victoria aren't looking much better, just 18 on the way for Bendigo, 23 degrees through the Mallee. Here in Melbourne, we're in for a wet and blustery night. The Surf Coast and Mornington Peninsula will get the showers first from around 9 or 10pm. Then they will move to the outer northern suburbs by the early hours. Heaviest through the outer east, up to 10 millimetres. The main band will clear out from the Dandenongs by mid-morning and only a light shower or two lingering after that, heading for 18 or 19 degrees. For Geelong, strong to gale force winds will persist until late tonight. Showers should clear before dawn, a top of 18 tomorrow. The city will get the showers a bit later, heaviest around midnight, clearing in the early morning, also heading for 18 degrees. Then a partly cloudy top of 21 on Thursday, 23 Friday, 25 on Saturday as we start the long weekend, a cloudy 21 on Sunday, 24 for the Moomba Parade on Monday, partly cloudy and 25 on Tuesday. Tonight a few showers around, but they should clear by the early morning, a low of 12, then a partly cloudy day with a top of 18, but it will feel colder under those westerly winds, Pete.
Okay, thank you, Lavinia.
Thanks, Brenton. Well, the skies might be a little bit grey, but music fans still looking very happy and excited tonight as they make their way into Adelaide Oval for the Ed Sheeran concert. So far, the showers are holding off. In fact, the greatest chance of showers is actually more so in the early hours of tomorrow morning, but we can't rule out just a light sprinkle for tonight. And right now in the city, it's around 18 degrees. Across the suburbs, we have seen a few light splashes around today, predominantly through the hills. We had half a millimetre at Mount Lofty, and it was cold there too, only 13 degrees, but we managed 23 at Elizabeth. Mostly dry through the north with temperatures in the mid-20s, 23 at Whyalla and 25 at Port Pirie. We sat in the low 20s from Nuriutspa through to Narracourt with a few splashes sprinkling in around Mount Gambier in the southeast. See that front on the charts there just slipping past to our south? That's the one that could deliver more showers in the early hours of tomorrow morning. Interstate Tassie's been copping some very strong winds and Hobart is looking cold and wet tomorrow. Canberra also on the cool side. Back in SA, a morning shower possible about Maitland tomorrow. Half a chance of a splash at Port Pirie, but nothing heavy. And the same goes for Clare. Temperatures are definitely on the cool side with 19 for Nuriutspa and Victor Harbour. And pretty much anywhere through the south could see those showers, especially in the early hours of the morning. On local waters, westerlies reaching 20 to 25 knots early in the morning and seas to 2 metres. But that's all easing back by nighttime. So around Adelaide suburbs tomorrow, now most of the showers are actually expected before dawn, but there could be a little bit left over during the morning before clearing up in the afternoon. 20 degrees for Elizabeth and Norlunga. We're also going for 20 degrees in the city tomorrow with an overnight low of around 14 degrees tonight. After that, we're certainly on a clearing trend as we make our way towards that long weekend. In fact, by Friday, we're up to a sunny 27 degrees. Saturday and Sunday also sitting just beautifully in the high 20s there. And even early next week, looking really nice and dry to round out that long weekend. So don't mind the grey skies now. It's a pretty decent looking forecast for that long weekend.
Yeah, what a buzz. Jessica, thank you.
Gary Youngbury is back with your full weather forecast now. Gaz, is it going to be as hot tomorrow?
Oh, pretty close to today, Andrew, and I'm afraid another one as we move into Thursday. So two more hot days to go before we'll get a little bit of relief with a southerly change. And then some showers. The potential of those showers could be a little bit heavier over the weekend. We'll get to that in a little more detail once we check out our weather map. A magic evening here in the city, but it will be quite a warm evening. Let's have a look at temperatures across southeast Queensland. And it was hot today. The hottest place in the southeast, Greenbank, 36 degrees. Ipswich, Bow Desert, and Gatton 35, here in the city 32 along with Caboolture and the Gold Coast, Redcliffe 30 and the Sunshine Coast 29. With the weather map, heavy rain, showers and storms about the tropics in the monsoonal trough, especially for Queensland's north and interior. A few hundred millimetres over the next few days for Queensland's northwest. It will push down through central Queensland and we could see some of that in the southeastern corner. We need to watch that over the next few days. For the capitals, a shower or two in Perth, Adelaide, Melbourne and Hobart. Sunny in Sydney with 31 degrees. Alice Springs 31, Darwin showers and storms. Queensland, we're looking at showers in Cairns, Townsville, Mackay, extending down into the Capricornia by the afternoon. Partly cloudy and very warm for Bundy, Gympie and Maryborough. Heavy rain inland, Mount Isa another 90 millimetres in the next 24 hours. Showers for Longreach with possibly heavy falls and cloudy skies in Roma. Here in the southeast, partly cloudy, light winds, slight chance of a very late shower, mild overnight, but tomorrow another hot one. Ipswich and Gatton expecting highs of 33 degrees. Moreton Bay, northerlies 15 to 20 knots, seas up to 2 metres offshore, while Brizzy tomorrow, partly cloudy, just a very slight chance of a late shower, maxing out at 32 degrees, but that overnight low 23. 7-day outlook, little cloud Thursday, cloudy with a few showers likely across Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and even into Monday. It could be a little bit heavy. We need to keep an eye on that. Ipswich, partly cloudy Thursday, shower or two Friday, Saturday, Sunday and into Monday. For the Goldie, mostly fine Thursday, chance of a late shower, cloudy with showers for Friday, Saturday, Sunday and into Monday. And on the Sunshine Coast, fine Thursday with evening showers, scattered showers Friday and into the weekend with a chance of a thunderstorm, even a couple of showers expected into Monday. But another 2 days of these well above average temperatures, team, but a little bit uncomfortable tonight as well.
All right, Gary, thank you.